What is going on, YouTube? It's J&J Gaming here. Today we're going to kick off the Let's Play series of Elden Ring. Started as a vagabond, probably going to be leaning towards a quality build, but depending on the weapons and how the game plays out, that could change. But as of right now, that is the plan. So let's get into it. And already I am fat rolling. Wizard's finger. Okay, that's how you use to write messages to other worlds. Let's see. Chapel of Anticipation. Gonna try to explore as many areas as we can during this playthrough. Oh, man, it is so nice to be able to jump. I wonder if there's anything back here. And does not seem to be. All right, what gear do we start with? The knight, vagabond knight armor, and a long sword with a heater shield. Don't see nothing over there. And this looks like a boss room. Wonder if this is like all the other Souls game where the first boss you encounter is designed to kill you. Well played, boss. Well played. So for this playthrough, I'm going to go ahead and let the cutscenes play. If in the future you guys would rather me just skip the cutscenes so you guys can watch them on your own, let me know and I will skip them.
Don't worry, Torrent. Fortune is on his side. We found him here, after all. One of his kind is sure to seek the Elden Ring. Even if it does violate the Golden Order.
flask of Crimson Tears, a flask of Cerulean Tears. Let's see, that's gotta be health and FP. Okay. Let's see what this thing has to say. Brave Tarnish, take the plunge of learning and remembrance. Recall the arts of war and your warrior's blood. It's a grace, resting at the side of the grace for a restore. We'll also refill your flasks. Okay, so this is basically a bonfire. No options. Memorize spell and sword chest. Pass the time. That's cool. You can change the time. Pretty cool. Wonder if that means different enemies spawn at different times of the day. That's fancy. Dodging. This fat roll's gotta go. Let's see. Does it? Just take our helmet off for now. Okay. It's you who's been shooting me. Acquire materials. In every corner of the lands between, you will find fruits and flowers, mushrooms and butterflies, and various other useful materials. They are used for crafting. Row a fruit. There's another one. Material used for crafting. Okay. Wielding armament. Left switch hand. Okay. All about that backstab. Oh. Okay, that's gotta be like my weapon art. It's pretty cool. Crouching. Okay, that's awesome. Stakes of Marika. Upon dying, you will be revived at the last site of grace that you visited. However, if there is a stake of Marika near where you died, you can choose to be revived there instead. Okay, that's pretty cool. Alright. Soldier of Godric. Okay, just a big beefy knight. And backstab number one. And is that enough? Yep, you're dead. Enemy felled. Doesn't look like there's any loot in this room. And it looks like we're back where we started. Okay, so that must be like the tutorial area. Strength. Let's see if this guy has anything to say now. Brief tarnish, take the plunge. Nope. Same thing as earlier. No, not yet. Precious item ahead. I don't think I have any stone sword keys. Nope. Well, we will have to come back to this once we get some of those. Alright, finger severer and tarnished furled finger. Let's see. Create a summon sign for cooperative multiplayer and sends one or another self home. Okay. So just your cooperative items. And we'll take this lift. See where this takes us. Limgrave. Wow, this place looks amazing. Let's see, what's this? In each area you may find effigies of martyrs. These effigies are summoning pools. You will find it easy to summon other players at these locations. Okay, so it's just kind of like a small golden effigy. What is that? Sends a co-op sign to summoning pools. There's another grace. Grace exists to guide the tarnished and lead them along the proper path. Even now, some sites of grace retain that power. Their golden rays will guide you along your way. Use your map to check the current position as well as the terrain and surrounding structures. You can update your map with new information by finding map fragments at steels along the road. You can also use the map to freely place beacons of light to serve as landmarks as you explore. Okay, so I guess you can... Okay, you can make waypoints for yourself.
Oh, yes. Tarnished, are we? come to the lands between for the Elden Ring? Of course you have. No shame in it. Unfortunately for you, however, you are maidenless. Without guidance, without the strength of runes, and without an invitation to the Round Table Hold, you are fated, it seems, to die in obscurity.
Well, I think I'm going to approach that knight, but he looks like he is going to rock my world, so we will see what happens, and if we have to, we will come back to take him on. Ow. Okay. Yeah, I think we're gonna end up coming back to this guy. I don't think I'm quite powerful enough. Upon dying, you'll be revived at the last sight of grace. You will drop any runes. If you die again, you'll lose the runes. Okay, standard souls. Let's get these runes and run. Mushroom. Oh, no. Ow. Stop chasing me. Check this place out. Church of Ella. What is this? At a smithing table, you can spend runes and smithing stones to strengthen your armaments. Somewhere in the lines between, you may meet a blacksmith who can make them even stronger. Okay. Smithing stone 1. Let's talk to this. You're tarnished.
I can see it. And I can also see that you're not after my throat. Then why not purchase a little something? I am Carly, purveyor of fine goods.
Purchase.
I am of a nomadic people, selling wares as I travel. The land has been tainted by madness since the shattering of the Elden Ring. It's only tarnished like yourself, who keep things from drying up entirely. Let's say you're a very welcome customer. You know, if you can spare the rooms, you should buy yourself a crafting kit. A crafting kit allows you to make basic items on your own. Essential, really, if you intend to survive out here for any duration. The kit costs a bundle, and I admit I do take my cut. But the important thing is that you survive. Every customer counts, after all.
Okay, so he wants me to buy a crafting kit. Okay, so these must be how you unlock more crafting, more items you can craft. 300. I guess let's go ahead and buy a kit. Those look like they are notes, throwing daggers, some arrows and bolts, a torch, which I'll go ahead and buy. Okay, that reveals, I guess you have to pop this to see summon signs. And then we have cookbooks to unlock more crafting recipes. Okay.
I'm glad you took my word. You've made an excellent choice.
If you have a crafting kit, you can make various items from materials that you find. Select item crafting from the menu. You can learn to craft more items by finding cookbooks. You will need crack pots or other containers to craft certain items. You will not be able to make more of those items than you have containers for. Container items will run out with use, but the containers themselves will remain. Okay, so I'm assuming that's like fire bombs and poison bombs. Let's see, what can we craft? Fire pot. Roped fire pot. That allows you to throw it behind you. Bone darts. Feed to torrent to restore HP. That must be the horse we get. Shines with a colored light when placed, serving as a guide. And Feral Calling Finger Remedy reveals co-op and hostile summoning signs. So, can't craft much yet. Fast travel to Sites of Grace. You can instantly travel to any Sites of Grace that you discovered. However, there are some dungeons and other areas where this cannot be done. Okay. Let's follow this road and see where it takes us. Let me just sit down at the grace real quick so I don't have to waste a flask. So that's where we came from. Hello, soldier. Bolts. There's another soldier right there. Ooh. Okay, so I guess if you break their stagger, you can get a critical hit on them. That's pretty cool. Wonder if that'll work on bosses as well. Let's see if we can get a good peek at the area. There's a bat over there. Oh, this place looks massive. Okay. Lots of stuff to explore, it seems. That guard counter is pretty nasty. At Groveside Cave. Summoning pool is not functional. So I guess we're gonna check out this cave. Alright, looks like we got wolves. And they just cornered me and killed me. Lovely. Try this again. I can't stand the fat rolling. All right, there's two down, three down. The leader of the wolves, because he is mean. Finally. Juking and dodging all my attacks. Alright. Acquire materials. Cave moss. There's an item there. Cracked pot. Container required for crafting cracked pot items. That's gotta be for like fire bombs. Let's get some more of this cave moss. Another wolf. Glowstones. Emits a faint light from the location it is placed. Golden rune 1. Used to gain a small number of runes. Okay. Fight. Beastman of Farum Azula. Oh, I didn't think I was gonna lunge forward that far. Infinitely lunge. Going into this without any flasks was a terrible idea. Get him this time, though. I'll have some healing potions. Right, I'm not even gonna worry about the wolves this time. I'm just gonna run right through, kill this boss. We've already explored everything else in the cave. Okay, that hurt. Let's get my runes real quick. Critical. And got him. Cool. Flame Drake Talisman. Let's see, what is that? Talisman. Boost fire damage negation. It's the only one we got, so that's what we're gonna equip. Doesn't look like there's anything else here. Root resin. Acquire materials. Alright, looks like we got a whole encampment. That looks like a gray soft in the distance. This one is active.
Greetings, traveler from beyond the fog.
I wonder if she's going to be like my maiden. Melina.
I offer you an accord. Have you heard of the Finger Maidens? They serve the two fingers, offering guidance and aid to the tarnished. But you, I am afraid, are maidenless. I can play the role of maiden, turning runes into strength. To aid you in your search for the Elden Ring. You need only take me with you to the foot of the Erd Tree.
Yeah, we're gonna accept
then
that.
Settle. Summon me by grace to turn runes into strength. Ah, another matter. I bequeath to you this ring.
Spectral Steed Whistle.
Use it to traverse great distances. It will summon a spectral steed named Torrent. Torrent has chosen you. Treat him with respect. Shall I turn your runes to strength? Let my hand rest upon you. For but a moment, share them with me.
With the level up menu, you can spend runes to increase your attributes.
The principles you would follow.
I I'm pretty sure I'm gonna do a quality build for this Let's Play playthrough, just so that we can try out most of the weapons, minus the magic ones. So, let's get dexterity to 15, and now we're at 14, 15, and we'll call it good there. You can equip 6 items in your pouches. Y and up used in pouch 1. Okay. Inventory. That's how you write messages. Into that for now. I'll just throw it on this bar. Okay, cool. Double jump. Okay, you can attack on either side. Vanquishing an enemy group will replenish, your flasks. Okay. So killing a whole group of enemies will replenish some flasks. That's pretty cool. I think that will conclude this first episode. I know this one was kind of boring. It's just kind of getting it all started, getting it set up. The next episode, we will continue to explore Limgrave. Catch you guys in the next one. Later.